Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. This is Dr. R. Balasashireka, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Science and Nutrition, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. Today we are going to see the module on Body Composition and Overview. The human body is a spectacular machine. It consumes tons to millions of food a year, but maintain its weight constantly without increasing. Humans are steadily and constantly harnessing and harvesting energy through their body metabolism to maintain energy balance. In order to maintain energy balance, energy intake must be equal to energy output. In certain conditions, this energy balance becomes unstable or unbalanced, leading to either increase or decrease in body weight. Body image is becoming more concerned, particularly among females, to maintain their slimness or thinness. Body image is nothing but the mental image of our own physical appearance and is influenced by many factors. One such factor is body weight and its distribution. Obesity is one of the burdens prevailing in the society pertaining to one's physical appearance. The term fatism has been coined to reflect the society's prejudice towards obesity. Thinness is currently preferred by majority of females. Being obese or overweight have a significant effect on physical and health performance of the individual. To point out, body fat is associated with various health problems. After studying this chapter, the learner would be able to understand the various components that comprise the human body composition, the various techniques involved in the assessment of body composition, the uses, advantages, and limitations of the technique. Okay, what is ideal body weight? We have too many questions regarding physical appearance, health, slimness, ideal body weight, etc. The society has created a virtual perception regarding physical appearance and ideal body weight. Ideal body weight may or may not be in par with optimal health. Efforts are being made to find an ideal body weight for good health. The terminology for ideal body weight has been shifted to healthy body weight in recent years. The current standard used is body mass index, abbreviated as BMI. Body mass index is also known as Cutellets index and is the ratio of body weight in kilograms to the height in meter squared. BMI is used as an screening index for health problems. Low or high BMI may be a symptom of serious illness or indicative of obesity. BMI reflects the individual's body composition, but BMI cannot be used for muscular individuals as it is an indicator of healthier body weight. Hence, other methods are needed to assess the actual body composition. Composition of the body. Human body contains many elements of the earth which are essential for normal physiological functioning. About 96% of the human body consists four elements, namely carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen in combinations. These four elements form the basis for structural components, namely protein, carbohydrate, fat, and water. The remaining 4% is composed of minerals like calcium, phosphorus, iron, potassium, sodium, chloride, and magnesium. Various techniques are available to measure the body components. The four major body components of interest are total body fat, fat-free mass, bone mineral, and body water, which have different densities. The density is 1.3 to 1.4 for bone, 1.1 for fat-free protein tissue, and 0.9 for fat when compared with 1, the standard density for water. The value of body density is used to determine the body fat percentage. Higher the density, greater is the fat-free mass, and a lower amount of Body fat. The six component model of body composition usually measured are total body fat, fat-free mass, bone mineral content, body water, soft tissue minerals, and glycogen. Let me see one by one in detail. Total body fat. Essential fat and storage fat together comprises the total body fat. Essential fat helps in proper functioning of body structures like brain, nerve tissue, bone marrow, heart tissue, and cell membranes. The essential fat in adult males is 3% and in females is additional 9 to 12%, that is 12 to 15% of body weight and is sex specific. Also, the essential fat varies with each individual. Storage fat acts as a depot for excess energy and the quantity varies considerably. 50% of the total body fat is subcutaneous fat that is found just under the skin and remaining around other body organs and helps in protection. The subcutaneous fat is separated from the connective tissue into smaller components, enters into the dermis and gives a dimpled quilt-like appearance to the skin known as cellulite. Cellulite, more common in women, contains higher concentrations of glycoproteins and is responsible for the waffle-like appearance of the skin. Other storage fat located in the abdominal area is referred to as visceral fat. This fat is located deep in the body and is associated with increased health risks. Fat-free mass. Fat-free mass consists primarily of protein and water, smaller amounts of minerals and glycogen. Fat-free mass is the main component of tissues of skeletal muscle mass and other organs include heart, liver, kidneys, etc. Fat is interchangeably used with lean body mass. Lean body mass includes essential fat. An individual with 20% body fat will have 80% fat-free mass. Bone mineral. Bones form the basic structure in our body, constituting about 50% of water and 50% of solid matter. Solid matter includes both proteins and minerals. Bones are involved in various metabolic processes. The total bone weight including water and protein is 12 to 15% of total body weight and mineral content is 3 to 4% of total body weight. Skeletal muscle mass. Skeletal muscle mass is a different type of mass of lean body mass. It is related to lean body mass as it is one of the parts that make up the overall lean body mass. It is influenced by factors outside the muscle, particularly water. Water is dependent of lean body mass. Visceral fat area. The body fat stored within the abdominal cavity is known as visceral fat. The fat is also found around important internal organs like liver, pancreas, and intestine. Visceral fat is an indicator of number of health issues including type 2 diabetes. Body water. The body weight of an adult is approximately 60% of water and 40% of dry weight materials. The water content in various tissues differs, with blood having water content whereas adipose tissue is relatively dry. The water concentration of the tissue is well regulated based on the needs under normal conditions. The percentage of the body weight depends on the weight of that tissue, which in turn is dependent on water content. Normal adult male has about 60% body water, 40% solid matter, of which 14% fat, 22% protein and 4% bone minerals. The body composition is influenced by many factors including age, sex, diet and type of physical activity. Age has a significant effect on body composition in the developmental years due to the formation of muscle and other body tissues. As age increases, muscle mass increases due to decrease in the type of physical activity. Sex of the individual up to puberty greatly influences the body composition. Girls deposit more fat and boys develop more muscle tissue. Diet influences body composition, like acute water restriction and starvation in a short run, and major effects are seen in long run. Increased fat stores are seen in individuals with chronic overeating. Physical activity with sound exercise practice helps build muscle and lose fat. Now let me look into the various measurements of body composition using different methods. Measurement of body fat is gaining interest among the population in recent years. The methods used to determine the body composition are given below. Underwater weighing. This technique is referred to as gold standard in body composition analysis. Underwater weighing or hydrodensitometry is used to determine the bone density and is based on Archimedes principle. The principle states that body immersed in a fluid is acted upon by a buoyancy force in relation to the amount of fluid the body displaces. The density of fat is less and density of bone and muscle tissue is more than water. The weight amount of fat will displace a larger amount of water, exhibiting greater buoyant effect than the corresponding weight of bone and muscle tissue. Depending upon the age and sex of the individual, different formulas are used to determine the body density. This technique has its own limitations, though widely used. This technique is time consuming and cannot be used for few individuals like athletes and older persons. Air displacement pyrethysmography. This is also known as body pyrethysmography. The subjects under study enter into a dual chamber pyrethysmography. The amount of air displaced is measured, which is comparable with the water displacement technique of underwater weighing. Body pod is a commercially available product, easy to operate, consuming little time than underwater weighing. The next method is skin folds. The common procedure for measuring subcutaneous fat is skin fold technique. For accurate results, skin fold is measured at different body sites, representative of total storage fat. This technique makes use of skin fold calipers, which is shown in the figure given below. Ultrasound computed tomography techniques are also used to measure the skin fold thickness and is more expensive than calipers. Waist circumference. Waist circumference is a measure of central fatness. Waist circumference greater than 35 inches for females and 40 inches for males is considered to be associated with health risks for chronic diseases. It is an indicator of lipid profile or insulin resistance. Body mass index. Body mass index is used as a global index of nutritional status and estimates the relative weight of an individual. It depends on sex and age of the individual. BMI is an indicator of type 2 diabetes, but BMI cannot distinguish fat and lean body mass. The table below gives the BMI, its status, and its relation with waist circumference. Bioelectrical impedance analysis. The principle involved in bioelectrical impedance analysis is the resistance to an electrical current that is applied to the body. The recorded resistance and water content are inversely proportional to each other, and hence greater the body density. This technique does not accurately measure lean body mass in individuals with abnormal body water supplies. The technique underestimates lean body mass as in athletes and overestimate in obese. Dual energy X-ray absorptiometry, abbreviated as DEXA DEXA. Dual energy X-ray absorptiometry is used to image body tissues, bone mineral content, fat free mass and body fat using computerized X-ray technique. Deep visceral fat may also be assessed by this expensive technique. Infrared interactants. Infrared light is allowed to pass through the tissues. The interaction of light with the tissue components is a measure of body fat. Anthropometry. Measure of body parts such as girths, neck, abdomen, bone diameters such as hip, shoulders, elbow and wrist. To predict the body fat and lean body mass, the girth and bone diameter. Girth measurements of hips, thigh, abdomen, buttocks and other body parts are important indicators of regional fat distribution and represent the anatomical distribution of fat throughout the body. Regional fat distribution is an indicator of health issues. Regional fat distribution is a measure of waist circumference and is measured using a flexible tape at the narrowest section of the waist. Waist circumference is a good indicator of regional fat distribution and do not provide an accurate measurement of deep visceral fat. Multi-component models. Combination of above said methods can reduce errors associated with single method. It also provides a measure of body fat, body water, bone mass and lean body mass and is feasible. Next, let me look into the regulation of body weight and its composition. Human body possesses a unique regulatory system in nature that helps in maintaining the energy balance, that is, energy intake and energy output. This regulation of human energy balance is complex, involving numerous mechanisms, which is well explained in the figure. Energy intake. Food intake is regulated by the central nervous system. The center of appetite control by the central nervous system, that is, brain, either create a sensation of satiety or stimulate food eating behavior. The action is dependent of a cascade array of afferent signals from different body systems. The afferent signals help to regulate the appetite on a daily basis or long-term basis by the interaction of the brain. The forebrain helps in the selection of foods we consume, and the brain stem helps in control of motor aspects like chewing and swallowing of eating. A small substructure, hypothalamus, between the forebrain and brainstem act as the center for appetite control. Hypothalamus has neural centers known as appetistat and helps in regulating the appetite. The hunger centers are present in the appetistat and stimulate eating behavior of an individual. A satiety center, when stimulated, helps in inhibiting the hunger center, producing a feeling of fullness. Both hunger center and satiety center have counter effect on inaction. Thus, the energy intake is controlled by specific neural receptors within the appetistat, monitored by afferent stimuli that either stimulate or inhibit the food intake. Along with the influence of appetite, various stimuli also influence the blood levels of nutrients, metabolites, hormones, neural stimuli from all parts of the body. Certain factors help in controlling the body weight on short-term or long-term basis. In controlling the body weight, certain afferent stimuli are involved. These include senses, stomach fullness, nutrient levels, body temperature, and hormones and neurotransmitters. Senses. The neural or hormonal senses are influenced by neural or hormonal activity and are stimulated by senses like light, sound, and smell. These senses stimulate or inhibit the appetite even before the food is ingested. Stomach fullness. Mechanical stretch receptors in the walls of the stomach generate neural activity either in empty or full stomach. Empty stomach stimulates hunger center and full stomach stimulates satiety center by various neural pathways. Nutrient levels. Receptors of the hypothalamus influence the nutrient levels. The blood levels of the nutrients are constantly monitored by the receptors of hypothalamus, liver, etc. Glucostatic theory, lipostatic theory and aminostatic theory well explain the energy nutrients. Glucostatic theory. Based on the levels of blood glucose, the change in food intake take place. A decrease in blood glucose will stimulate the appetite, whereas an increase will decrease the appetite. Lipostatic theory and aminostatic theory emphasize the same mechanism for fat and protein or amino acids respectively. Byproducts of major nutrients, that is carbohydrates, fat and protein metabolism, influence the appetite by the action of neurotransmitters like serotonin and norepinephrine in the hypothalamus. Body temperature. In response to the changes in body temperature, the thermostat in the hypothalamus influences the feeding center. An increase in body temperature will inhibit the appetite in conditions like fever. Hormones and neurotransmitters. Hormones like insulin, thyroxine, and number of peptides and neurotransmitters like leptin are involved in the feeding behavior. Next, energy expenditure. The other side of the energy balance equation is the energy expenditure. The best way of losing energy is by doing exercise. Majority of the energy is spent for carrying out the basic metabolic reactions of the body. The expended energy on daily basis is referred as basal energy expenditure or resting energy expenditure. This basal energy expenditure is involved in the regulation of body weight through several mechanisms like brown fat. Brown fat, less than 1% of body fat, comprises of most fat tissues in the body and is distinct from the white fat. It is found in small amounts around the neck, back and chest areas. These areas have high metabolic rate and produces heat without the production of ATP molecules. During non-shivering thermogenesis, that is, after meal or exposure to cold, the activity of brown fat tissue may either rise or lower. White fat tissue and muscle tissue. Both white fat tissue and muscle tissue experience thermogenesis with no production of ATP molecules when a food rich in dietary fat is consumed. Hormones. Energy metabolism is affected by the levels of hormones from thyroid and adrenal glands accordingly. Brown adipose tissues are stimulated by triiodothyronine and thyroxine secreted by the thyroid gland. Increased energy expenditure is exhibited when there is an increased secretion of epinephrine and vice versa. Changes in thermogenesis in adipose or muscle tissues are also seen due to other hormones. Non-exercise activity thermogenesis, abbreviated as NEAT, NEAT. Non-exercise activity thermogenesis accompanies physical activity and volitional exercise and have a significant effect on the daily exercise regimen. Feedback control of energy intake and expenditure. The metabolic processes of human body is controlled or regulated by numerous physiological systems called as feedback systems. Control of body weight by feedback system function on both daily and yearly basis. While eating a meal, stomach expands and nerve impulses are sent to hypothalamus from the stomach to suppress food intake, thus help to maintain overall energy balance. Body stores of carbohydrate, protein and fat are regulated on short-term basis or daily. Excess carbohydrate and protein cannot be stored by human body because of its limited capacity, but can store high capacity of fat. So, the intake of carbohydrate and protein is regulated by changes in blood sugar and amino acid levels. Blood lipids and other factors help in maintaining body fat balance in short-term basis. Body makes certain metabolic adjustments for weight according to the normal body temperature of 98.4 degree Fahrenheit. Body adapts to return to normal even if some deviation from the set point of weight occurs and is known as adaptive thermogenesis, that is, either to increase or decrease the energy production to generate heat. Leptin, a regulating hormone produced by OB gene in the adipose cells, imbalance the body weight, thus controlling long-term control. This is reflected by changes in body fat stores, that is, body produce more leptin when there is more body fat and vice versa. When the leptin level increases, gets released into the blood, reaches hypothalamus and inhibit the production of neuropeptide Y, abbreviated as NPY. NPY, that is neuropeptide Y, stimulates food intake and reduces the energy expenditure by decreasing resting energy expenditure. Thus, fat gets accumulated in the body. Decreased levels of NPY will suppress hunger. Conversely, decreased fat intake on dieting produces little leptin, having an inhibitory effect on NPY production. Increased levels of NPY stimulate hunger, reduce energy expenditure, resist the effect of diet, and promote restoration of losing weight. This gives the sequence of how energy expenditure takes place on the basis of food intake and either lose the weight or gain the weight. Genetic and environmental factors. Genetic factors also predispose in the development of obesity. They include craving sweets and high fat foods, impaired function of insulin, cortisol and other hormones, reduced level of growth hormone, low plasma leptin concentration, suppression of appetite control centers by nutrients and hormones, large number of fat cells, metabolic efficiency of storing fat, reduced resting energy expenditure, decreased total energy expenditure, decreased rate of fat oxidation, reduced physical activity and need, reduced energy expenditure during exercise. Toxic environment also plays an important role predisposing to obesity. Consumption of high fat and high sugar foods, supersized portion of junk and fast foods, discouraging physical activity also leads to obesity. In conclusion, body composition helps to identify the risk factors that lead to unhealthy, even fatal conclusions. Various different landmarks on the body to record skinfold measures are dealt with. It summarizes the advantages and disadvantages of different body composition techniques, including skinfold method, bioelectrical impedance, underwater weighing, etc. Different body composition allows the measurement of total body fat, fat-free mass, bone mineral content, body water, soft tissue minerals and glycogen, and help identify the degree of BMI and its effect on health. It is important to recognize that there is no single measurement method that allows for the measurement of all tissues and organs, and no method is error-free. Furthermore, bias can be introduced if a measurement method makes assumptions related to body composition proportions and characteristics that are inaccurate across different populations. The clinical significance of the body compartment to be measured should first be determined before a measurement method is selected, as the more advanced techniques are less accessible and more costly.